Hello, my name's Rich Haller. I'm here with Wm.T.Spaeder Company. I'm a sprinkler fitter foreman. We are at a local hospital and patient care tower. Down in the basement, the water supply room where the fire pump's located. The water supply enters the building for the fire system through this main off of the city, comes in to a backflow preventer to stop any cross-contamination, feeds into the fire pump, which has a bypass in case the pump is out of order so that city pressure can feed the fire protection system. This system has check valves in place so that each pump is isolated. The small pump is what we call a jockey pump. It is basically a maintenance pump for the system. It boosts the city water pressure from 80 psi to 173 psi. If the system required a small amount of water or small pressure increase due to temperature gain or loss, or a leak, a small leak, that would maintain it. Over here we have two controllers, which are all electronic. I have a half inch sensing line on each one, a digital readout from a pressure switch on the inside. That monitors the pressure in the system, tells the pump when to turn on, when to turn off. This is for the service pump, the jockey pump. This is for the fire pump. It's a lot larger because it has more voltage. This side is the normal power coming from the grid. This is the transfer switch side. So this would be the emergency generator power. If this power fails, it automatically switches over, tells the generator to start. The generator for the building starts and feeds the fire pump from this panel. If the power comes back on, it'll automatically switch back over. Electricians do all the electrical work. When we're ready to do a test, we have a representative from our supplier for the pump and the controller. We have the electricians, usually the building maintenance supervisor, fire marshal. There's a lot of people involved. Best case scenario, you have somebody from each of those areas and also from our design team so that they can verify and resolve any issues or problems. Not all systems require a fire pump. This is an 8-story building if you include the basement levels. The reason for the fire pump is with the gain in elevation, you lose pressure. You have 5 to 10 pounds per floor. The system was designed to run at the worst case scenario on the highest floor and have a minimum pressure. Without the pump, they would not have that pressure available. If the building was not so high, they may not have needed the fire pump. The pump head on this is actually very small. This is the actual fire pump. This is the motor. It's a high speed motor. So it's lower horsepower, more energy efficient, but runs higher RPMs, which means you need a smaller pump to achieve your flow rating. Your electric fire pump is probably one of the two most typicals. In a remote situation or a warehouse, you would have a diesel driven. So it would be a diesel motor instead of an electric motor. There's vertical pumps to go into tanks or shafts. There's horizontal pumps such as this. Like I said, the size and configuration varies along with the diameter of the pipe based on what water is required and what the city provides, how much you have to increase it to get the optimum result. Once the water leaves the pump into the system, we have an alarm valve. We have a shutoff valve. Then we have an alarm valve that covers the entire building. It has a pressure switch on the back side that anytime any water is flown, that will activate and tell you that there's a potential fire or an alarm. This 6-inch pipe feeds the hose valves for the fire department in the stairwells and also supplies the water to each and every floor. Each floor has its own control assembly with a flow switch that detects water movement, a gauge for pressure, a drain for testing and service. So in the stairwells, the basement is different because of its location. In the main stair tower, each floor has one of these assembly that controls specifically that floor. So it's easier for the fire department to know where the problem is. If there was a fire, the panel at the main entrance, the fire alarm panel, would read each flow switch and tell them what floor they had a problem on so they knew right where to go. After the initial installation, we have to do a hydrostatic test of 200 pounds for 2 hours. If the system pressure is greater than 200, we have to go 50 pounds over that. So you could be looking at 250 pounds pressure for hydrostatic test. It has to hold for 2 hours. That's on all system piping in the building. Each device has to be tested with the alarm system when it's completely installed. The jockey pump is tested for rotation, pressure, and the set points on the controller are adjusted for each system individually. The fire pump, to put it into service, on this one specifically being electric, you have the main power source coming in, and then you have the transfer switch, which also gives you the feed from the building's generator, emergency supply. So it has to be tested a number of times to make sure it's starting and stopping at the correct pressures, making sure the RPMs are correct, that it doesn't overheat, and also that we can get the calculated flow of water needed to meet the requirements of the design. That is done on the outside of the building through a test header that has hose valves on it that is fed from this line coming off the fire pump, is piped directly to the outside of the building just for testing, which is done annually to verify that we still have the same water pressure coming into the building and verifying that our pump is still performing as it was designed and originally tested. The system doesn't consume water. It's generally stagnant. So once you fill it, the water stays in there until such a time you have to test devices, which is quarterly or annually, depending upon the requirements of the building or the insurance company. At that point, you would flow water and test each device. You would introduce fresh water into the system for that purpose. I've been on this project for a little over a year. We didn't get on site until the building shell was pretty much intact, except for the exterior walls. We actually started on the upper floors, which are shell space, because we didn't have to wait for other mechanicals. So we could start retrofitting our pipe in and work our way back down to the finished out areas and into the mechanical room. Each job is different. I guess each hurdle on each job is case specific. With a fire pump, normally we don't have as much room in a building, so we have to put it in a more compressed space, a different configuration. That's where the design is crucial, and the engineering is paramount. If they don't do the job properly, we can't make it all fit in a timely manner. Access, this is in the basement. You don't just pick that up and walk it through a door. I mean, it's a heavy piece of equipment. The controllers are large, heavy, and very expensive. So logistics, getting them on site on the proper time, having the equipment to move them, put them in place, and having the manpower to do it safely is very important. Thanks for joining us today for Wm.T.Spaeder at the Patient Care Tower. And don't forget to check us out on YouTube.